Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to Falls Cable Access Spectrum Channel 14. We are coming to you live from Menominee Falls High School tonight with an exciting Greater Metro Conference boys varsity football matchup here at Schumann Stadium between the visiting Marquette University Hilltoppers and the Menominee Falls Phoenix. This is going to be a good one tonight, we hope, folks. Both these clubs coming in at 3-1. Both of them 2-0 in conference, coming off big conference wins both last week as Menominee Falls beat down their nemesis Germantown 53-21, and Marquette handled Brookfield East handily and easily 49-0. So we are getting right to the action here.
Back from Menominee Falls, Kaiser Slivick.
Number 18, Eric Schmidt, set to kick here for the Hilltoppers. Deep for Menominee Falls, number 20, Laquan Beeks, watch out for him. And number 3, Tysis Levitch. Schmidt appears ready. And here he comes. Kick is away. And who gets the touchback? Menominee Falls will start at their own 20. We'll see what Coach Regent Smith has in mind for this Marquette team, who is 3-1. Their only loss, the first game of the year. Actually, both these clubs, their only loss is first game of the year. Marquette coming in losing 21-14 to Arrowhead. Menominee Falls losing 49-41 to Slinger. Wilson Kirshner, Menominee Falls senior quarterback, with Joey Cuck, his trusty sidekick by his side, and the give is to Cuck. Cuck tries the left side, bounces it back to the right, and he is swarmed under. Going to be a loss of 4 on that one. Late flag, we'll have to see what this is about.
Penalty flag on the plate.
Still talking it over here, I haven't seen anything. Got a face mask against the Hilltoppers. That'll lessen the sting of that loss on first down.
Menominee Falls offensive line, the moving company. 5 men in the truck. Number 55, Isaiah Wayne. 66, Cooper O'Melia.
We need 10.
All right,
let's go.
Here we go. First and 5 for the Phoenix. And again, once again to Cuck. Kirshner throws a block. Cuck, again, thinks left, comes back to the right side. And he takes the ball out to about the 43-yard line. Pickup of 18 for the Phoenix and a first down for Menominee Falls.
First down, ball's up to the 42-yard line. The rest of the offensive line. Number 70, Benny O'Meara. 72, Joe Sadowski. And 73, Stevens, Scott III.
So here we go, first and 10 from their own 42-yard line. Kirshner waiting on the snap. Oh, Kirshner drops snap. He recovers, takes it himself, and Kirshner down the sideline. Kirshner out across midfield, out to the Marquette 40-yard line. Didn't start well, but kind of reminiscent of our own green and gold on Sunday, and that drop snap turns into a positive play, but there is laundry on the field. Let's see what this one is. There's an illegal block in the back against the Phoenix. So,
block in the back against the Menominee Falls.
So replaying a first down here, but that is going to take them all the way back to the 34-yard line. So, first and 16 now for the Phoenix. Scotty Hawkins goes in motion. Kirshner, his first pass of the night, intended for number 8, his tight end Mason Holseth, defended by Josh Knacker for the Hilltoppers. Incomplete.
Brings up 2nd and 18.
I was a little off there on my call. Sorry about that. So Kirshner comes into tonight's game. 33 of 61 on the season for 650 yards, 9 touchdowns, and an interception, while chipping in another 147 yards and a couple of TDs on 33 carries. Joey Cuck, he comes in 105 carries for 879 yards and 11 TDs. A couple of catches for 75 yards and another touchdown. So, Kirshner's pass. Tended again for Holseth. Bryce Roeder, senior linebacker there for the Hilltoppers, goes up high, knocks that one down, gets a hand on it. So now Menominee Falls find themselves way behind the sticks. 3rd and 18 for the Phoenix. See what Coach Regent Smith has in mind here. This defense for Marquette is good this year, ladies and gentlemen. Little screen set up to Cook, good plan. But the Hilltoppers don't leave him much room, and he is met by a group of them. Man initially by number 24, Frank Briscoe. Sorry, Patrick O'Brien. He's dropped, and that is 4th and long for the Phoenix. No gain on that play, very little. Eli Elm into punt.
Back deep is Murphy Monreal.
Elm's kick. Short one. Looked like somebody might have got a hand on that one. Murphy Monreal was deep for the Hilltoppers, but he did not get a chance on it. Evan Hoffman downs that one for the Phoenix before it can roll backwards anymore. And Marquette starts itself off in good position here. 1st and 10 from their own 43-yard line, so relatively short field here for the Hilltoppers. Peter McDevitt, senior quarterback, set to lead the Hilltoppers here. Little fake, McDevitt goes deep right away. And that ball is incomplete. Intended for number 4, Cam Russell.
Broken up by Nolan's. The offensive line for Marquette. Number 50, Matt Fessel. 51, Dan Miller. 55, Jack Hunt. 57, Andrew.
McDevitt's second play. Give up the middle to running back Tommy Novotny, sophomore for the Hilltoppers. Novotny picks up about 7 on that one. Novotny comes in as the leading rusher here for the Hilltoppers. The Hilltoppers are quick to the line. Another little fake, throws that one underneath, and he finds his man, number 17, Thad Hoffman. Catch is good.
Pass is complete.
All the way up to the Menominee Falls 37-yard line. Marquette again going fast here. Keeping those defenders on the field. Another give to Novotny. Novotny is met though and driven backwards by that Phoenix defense.
Stuffed on the play by Tavier Johnson. Loss of 2 on the play.
Tavier Johnson was a nice play there, meeting him and stopping him in the backfield. Here Marquette goes right away again. McDevitt on the roll to left. He is going to keep. He is hunted down and dropped initially by number 7, Colton Miller, helped out by number 3, Tysus Levitch. Picks the ball up to the Menominee Falls 31. And Marquette's going to keep their offense on the field. 3rd and about 4 here. Straight ahead again to Novotny. This one might depend on the spot here.
By Isaiah Wade and Steven Scott. Brings up 4th down.
So he was held short. Isaiah Wade and Steven Scott doing a nice job there of standing him up and holding him. McDevitt back up. Novotny in the backfield with McDevitt. A give again. Novotny straight ahead, and he goes through the line untouched into the end zone, 28 yards for the Hilltoppers. And they are first to strike here with 7:46 on the scoreboard.
Menominee Falls 0.
Your score at the moment, Marquette 6, Menominee Falls 0. Extra point upcoming here. Menominee Falls will need to make sure here, no more short fields. They're going to have to tighten up because, again, this Marquette team, we'll talk about their defense in a couple minutes, but their defense is having quite a year, even with the one loss.
That's the point by Eric Schmidt. That is good. Marquette 7, Menominee Falls 0.
So Eric Schmidt puts that one through, and now with 7:46 on the clock here in the first quarter, Marquette 7, Menominee Falls 0. Marquette kickoff upcoming. Menominee Falls looking to answer after that drive and score. Again, talking about these two teams, both coming in 3-1, both 2-0 in conference. Marquette, you expect that from. That's what they are. Menominee Falls, it's been a couple years since they've had strong success in the Greater Metro Conference, so it's nice to see them rebounding well and having a good year this year. 3-1 overall, 2-0 in conference. They've beat Brookfield East and Germantown, as well as a wild win over New Berlin West. Their only loss coming in the season opener is Slinger. And Marquette 3-1, 2-0 in conference. Their only loss also, like I said earlier, coming in the home or the opener of the season against number 6 in the state ranked Arrowhead. A 21-14 loss to Arrowhead in that first game of the season. They have played similar opponents to Menominee Falls besides their non-conference games, but they do have a big win over Catholic Memorial, perennial strong team. And that kick into the end zone, Menominee Falls with the touchback once again. Marquette's other wins against the same Germantown and Brookfield East teams that Menominee Falls has beaten. So we all know there's no direct correlation, but it's interesting that both of them have had pretty much the same schedules coming into this season, besides their non-conference games. So Kirshner has him back to the line. Second series here for the Phoenix. Looking to throw right away. Kirshner hit initially in the backfield, gets away for a second, but then loses the ball. Falls on it. Loss of about one for the Phoenix on that play. Second and 11.
Loss of one. Second and 11.
Menominee Falls the last couple weeks especially has had a really, really nicely balanced offense against Germantown, against Brookfield East. So we'll be seeing how they play that out here against this defense. Talking about this defense, again, their only loss to Arrowhead, currently ranked number 6 in the state, and that was a 21-14 game. This is a team that has not given up a point in the last three games, this Marquette defense. Joey Cook stood up, driven back.
Met by Matthew Griffith
no gain. Maybe gets the one back to make it a third and 10 now for Menominee Falls. They've only allowed 21 points all year. They're only allowing 177 yards per game. So Menominee Falls has got to bring their offensive A game here tonight to make something happen against this team. Kirshner here, third and 10. Cook in the backfield. Kirshner looks to keep straight ahead.
Wilson Kirk with the keeper.
Small pickup, short pickup for the Phoenix. And that will make it fourth and about 8 for the Phoenix. Once again, not much doing on that drive. So Eli Elm making his second appearance as the punter for the Phoenix. I think last time looked like Marquette was able to get a finger on it. Murphy Monreal deep for the Hilltoppers as he's set up at his own 43-yard line. Big pressure again. Elm gets it away. Unrail gets the skip right into his hands, and he takes the corner on the right side, and he is up the sideline, and he is going to go. Murphy Monreal, 57-yard punt return. I do not see any flags on the field, and just like that, over 5 minutes remaining here in the first quarter, Menominee Falls finds itself in a 13-0 hole.
After the extra point, we'll turn it over to the prep band.
So Eric Schmidt coming on to kick the extra point for the Hilltoppers. A little delay here. If we get that sorted out. And we are set. Peter McDevitt pulling double duty besides being the quarterback. He's also holding on the kicks here. Miller's kick is up and through. So 5:23 in the first still remaining. Your score, Marquette 14, Menominee Falls nothing. As we prepare for this kickoff, be the third one for Menominee Falls. From a receiving standpoint, third one for Eric Schmidt for the Hilltoppers. Menominee Falls needs to pull a little of that momentum, needs to make something happen here.
All proceeds going to programs, both athletic and academic. Maybe you support the kids, it doesn't fit simply. Again, the quarter timeouts are an option. Also, it's still early in the school year, great time to become a Booster Club member. See the high school website for details.
Eric Schmidt set to kick off here. Beek and Sislevich deep for the Phoenix. Big leg from this Marquette kicker. He has cleared the end zone on every single one of his kickoffs so far, and all of his extra points have cleared the upright and would have been good from a field goal perspective of 40 plus easily. So definitely the ability to drive that ball for this Marquette kicker. All right, Menominee Falls, let's see what you got. Third drive, trailing by 14 with 5:23 remaining in the first. You're watching Falls Cable Access Spectrum Channel 14. I'm Marlon Hestatoon. We are at Schumann Stadium at Menominee Falls High School for this evening's Greater Metro Conference varsity football matchup, visiting Marquette Hilltoppers and the Menominee Falls Phoenix. Kirsten with a give to Cook. Tries the left, not much doing. Maybe a pickup of one. Second and nine now for the Phoenix. Menominee Falls has typically been able to open holes and run almost at will most of the season, so this is a new experience for them here. Kirshner takes the snap. Little quick out there to Scott Hawkins. Hawkins makes the catch out across the 31 to 32 yard line. First down, Menominee Falls.
First down. Depending on the play was Mitchell Midwell.
You might need to do a little bit of that to soften these guys up and help their offensive line have to face a few less guys, a few less white shirts in that box. Start opening things up for Cook.
32-yard line.
Cook straight ahead. He's out to the 35. Pickup of three-ish, we'll say there.
Backed up by Nick Kaminsky.
Second and seven for the Phoenix.
And a three on the play. Second and seven. Ball at the 35-yard line.
Definitely feels like, what's the phrase they use? Stay ahead of the chains. Game here for Menominee Falls. Make sure you get three or four on first, three or four on second. Make third down manageable. Quentin Pfeiffer goes in motion. Kirshner drops back. And he's got the aforementioned Pfeiffer complete out to the Menominee Falls 46-yard line, 45-yard line. First and 10 for the Phoenix.
That's good for Menominee Falls. First down.
This is what they need. Get the ball moving. Get those couple first downs out of the way. Start building on success after success.
Ball started the Phoenix. 45 yards.
Kirshner with 3:15 on the clock, ready for the snap. Oh, got a little motion there on Holseth. Now he falls, is going to take a couple steps back, making it first and 15 for the Phoenix.
Ball starting, how many balls?
Definite Friday night light atmosphere here tonight, ladies and gentlemen. We love that you're joining us, but you know what? You should be out here watching this one, because we got the cheerleaders cheering, we got the pep band playing.
First and 15.
Both sides of the stands pretty full. Great atmosphere here at Schumann Stadium. So first and 15 from their own 40. Kirshner sits up, two wide receivers, a couple of tight ends. Joey Cook takes this one over the left side. A little bit more space for Cook as he pushes his way forward. Pickup of about seven, making it second and eight now for the Phoenix. Good run there by Cook. Good quick hit using the couple extra bodies on the line. Opening up that left side. Once again, second and eight from their own 47. Holseth goes in motion. Kirshner on the snap. This one, Cook, you try the right side. Cook puts the foot on the ground, turns it back after
pop off the right side.
Making his initial move.
Final stop by Ryan Tomlinson.
Pickup of almost four, three there for the Menominee Falls. No, it's going to be banked. So third and six now for the Phoenix. Ball sitting at the Menominee Falls 49-yard line. Not sure. Past weeks, this has been probably a four-down territory for Menominee Falls. I don't know if it is this week against this team. Kirshner on the snap. Looks, throws. Oh, Kirshner's pass. I think he threw it high to his intended receiver because Holseth hadn't turned around yet. That one almost picked off. Kirshner got away with it there. This pass is a little high. In and out of the defender's hands. Eli Elm is on the punt. Monreal back again, standing at his own 15-yard line here. Elm, the left-footed kicker, gets that one away. Hits at the 25-0 and takes a Marquette bounce. Colton Miller very alertly takes that ball and knocks it out of bounds. Of course, he wasn't trying to knock it out of bounds. I think that would be a flag, but knocks it out of bounds to stop it from rolling anymore and giving Marquette any more free yards. So it'll be first and 10 for the Hilltoppers. First and 10 from their own 29-yard line. So a 22-yard punt there for Elm is the net out of that one. McDevitt on again. McDevitt's give. Novotny over the left side, and oh, I don't think he's going to be caught. Novotny, 71 yards, one play. No flags on the field, so this is going to stand. 1:25 on the clock. Marquette jumps out to a 20-0 lead. I think Marquette's got about 6 offensive plays so far tonight. Schmidt once again on to kick another extra point. That is up, and that is good. So, again, 1:25 remaining in the first quarter. Your score, Marquette 21, Menominee Falls 0. That's a backbreaker. They moved the ball, had a little bit of success, got some first downs. Punted away, but have Marquette back on their own territory finally. And one play, one long run, and ball's coming right back to the offense, down 7-1. So again, statement stays the same. Beeks and Sislevich deep for Menominee Falls. Schmidt ready to kick off. Had to keep fighting here, Falls, because regardless of what happens in this game, it doesn't get any easier as number 3, Brookfield Central, comes rolling in next week. I apologize, we go to Brookfield Central for that one. So definitely a frying pan and fire situation here in the next couple weeks for the Phoenix. And Sussex Hamilton out on the horizon also. Sussex Hamilton also ranked in D1. Kirshner with the give to Cook straight ahead. He runs into a wall of white shirts. No gain there for Joey Cook. 2nd and 10 now for the Phoenix. Yeah, so including this one, 3 of the next 4 games for this Phoenix team are against ranked in-state opponents. Like I said, Marquette today, who's ranked number 8 in Division 1. Next week, Brookfield Central is ranked number 3 in Division 2. And 2 weeks after that, number 5 in Division 1, Sussex Hamilton. Now that will all change by then because these teams, actually Central and Sussex, are playing each other tonight. Kirshner going deep. He airs that one out. Intended for number 8, Mason Holseth. That one falls incomplete. 3rd and 8 now for the Phoenix.
Brings up 3rd down.
Patrick O'Brien, number 24 on the coverage there on Holseth. Third and 8 here for the Phoenix from their own 22-yard line. Feels like this is an important first down here, and you hate to say that, but Kirshner on the roll, lofts that one up, and again, in and out of the hands of a receiver, in and out of the hands of a defensive back. Intended for Cook off his hands, through the hands of Malik Lee for the Hilltoppers. So 4th and 8 now from Menominee Falls. Eli Elm on to punt again. Familiar tune so far tonight for this Phoenix offense. Elm gets that one away. Monreal sitting at his own 44. Ball lands right about the 40 yard line, and then takes a nice Menominee Falls bounce. I'm sorry, his own 40, as he hit about the 45, bounces down to about the Menominee Falls. Get down to the Marquette 33. Yeah, we'll call it the 33 yard line. So first and 10 now for Marquette. Get one play here, and then we'll go to the end of the first quarter more than likely, as there's only 9.9 seconds remaining. So Menominee Falls defense should be fresh, should be ready. Let's see what Peter McDevitt and team throw at them, though. McDevitt on the snap, but he loses it, was able to flop forward and land on that one. That one lost on the exchange there. And that will bring an end to quarter number one. Your score, Menominee Falls 0, Milwaukee Marquette 21. We are Falls Cable Access. You're watching us on Spectrum Channel 14 or hopefully on YouTube. We are live here at Menominee Falls High School, Schumann Stadium, Jeskowitz Petroff Field. And this is Greater Metro Conference Football. Thanks for joining us. I'm Marlon Hestetune. And Menominee Falls looking to right the ship here in the second quarter as they give up 3 touchdowns in that first quarter. One on a long punt return, one on a long run, and the other on a medium length run. So we'll see what they can do here as we flip the end of the field. All right, we are set. Devitt on the snap again, hand off to Novotny. Novotny nearly breaks another one. He is tripped up after a gain of about 16 on that. First and 10 for the Hilltoppers.
We're asking people to kind of side a little bit. We've got people looking for seats for a proper game.
Colton Miller and Anderson.
Room on either side to slide over.
On the tackle there, McDevitt's first down play. And he is going to air it out as he throws this one deep up over the top. And that one is incomplete, intended for number 4, Cam Russell. Cam Russell, senior, 6'3" senior receiver, comes in as the Hilltoppers' top receiver. 19 catches, 337 yards on the year, 4 touchdowns. So he's having a nice season. Second and 10 now for the Phoenix. Or I'm sorry, for the Hilltoppers. Devitt on the keep. He is under pressure right away. He will try to get away, and he does escape off the right side. Pickup of about 6. Robert Green is on the early pursuit. Cole Gagner makes the tackle in the open field there. Hand off to Novotny again over that left side. Novotny straight ahead. Pick up about 9 on that one. And that will be enough for another Hilltopper first down as they move those chains. First and 10 from the Menominee Falls 32 yard line. McDevitt with the play action. Throws that one over the middle. Cam Russell bouncing off hits, breaking tackles, and finding his way to the end zone. 10:36 in the second quarter, and the Hilltoppers are back in for another touchdown, making your score Marquette, Milwaukee Marquette 27, Menominee Falls 0. Extra point upcoming. Oh, there was a flag on the field.
Once again, you can slide in a little bit, you can get some more folks in the seats.
That was illegal motion they called on Marquette. So that's a sigh of relief for all the Menominee Falls fans here and abroad.
So first and 15 now for the Hilltoppers. All right, we've got everything sorted out. Ball is marked. We are set to go. Little shovel pass there on the Peyton Roby Brown going in motion. McDevitt with the snap, push it forward to him. Gets back the penalty and a few more. Makes it 2nd and 7 for the Hilltoppers. McDevitt and Novotny in the backfield. Devitt over the middle. Cam Russell goes up and snatches that one out of the air. More yellow on the field. Before I announce anything dramatic, let's see what's going on here. Same thing. Marquette is struggling. So, Menominee Falls, the recipient of a couple of well-timed flags there. The benefactor, Marquette's a recipient. We'll move them back. 2nd and 12 now for the Hilltoppers.
Come on, defense!
McDevitt drops, looks, throws it deep. And this one intercepted. Tandem interception there, but Eli Allen comes away with it, brings it out of the end zone, and he is dropped. They're at the 14-yard line, but turnover. Menominee Falls, 1st and 10. Menominee Falls making the stand there. Able to come away with the turnover and be 1st and 10 for this Phoenix. So Kirshner brings them up. Going with 3 wide receivers. Joey Cook in the backfield, 1 tight end. Ball is spotted, 1st and 10. Menominee Falls from their own 14-yard line. 9:37 remaining here in the second quarter. Mason Holseth goes in motion. Straight ahead with Joey Cook. And he bounces off a couple of Hilltopper defenders. Out to the 20-yard line. Pickup of 6 for the Phoenix. 2nd and 4. I apologize earlier. There's penalties that Hilltoppers got called on. Illegal lineman downfield, an eligible receiver downfield, so they're having trouble with their lineman drifting a bit past that 2-yard bubble that they're allowed to stay in on pass plays. That was very, very good for the Phoenix, though, as that helped kill that drive and put them in a position to throw that long pass. So Menominee Falls will take them and take the turnover. So here's Kirshner, Cook again in the backfield. Kirshner snap, looks, throws. Oh! That one intended for Corey Johnson. Johnson can't haul it in. 3rd and 4 now for the Phoenix. Again, this feels like one of those moments. Put together a drive, get on the scoreboard, feel differently about things as the second quarter winds. Kirshner sends Holseth in motion. And we've got some motion for the Phoenix. This is going to back them up. False start on Menominee Falls, so we'll make it. Third and 9 now for the Phoenix.
Brings up 3rd and 9.
Again, not where they want to be. You all know this, but we got to talk about something, right? If they keep going backwards, that's what we're going to talk about. Now he falls 4 wide receivers. Joey Cook in the backfield. Holseth again goes in motion. Kirshner looking. He pulls it down and he takes off and he is dropped just past the 20-yard line.
Tracked down by Bryce Royer.
Pick up of about four on that. Not enough. And it's going to be fourth down, and Eli Elm will come on to kick this one away again for the Phoenix. Monreal deep again. Standing at his own 44-yard line, awaiting the kick from Elm. Elm kicks this one away. Monreal muffs it, but gets it back, picks it up at about the 48. And he is tracked down and dropped by Corey Johnson. And that after a short gain, so that's where Marquette will start first and 10 from their own 49-yard line. As they say in the big leagues, they are plus side of the field to start this drive. If Menominee Falls continues to figure this Marquette offense out a little bit more and a little bit more. Devitt set, Novotny in the backfield. Runner in motion, give it to Novotny. Tries the right side, and he is wrapped up and dropped. Short gain, brought down by number seven, Colton Miller.
And Steven Scott. Gain of three.
Pick up a three, second and seven. Hilltoppers with four wide receivers. A little short pitch to Novotny. Novotny turns the corner and he is free again. Down the sideline, across the 10, into the end zone. But there is yellow on the field. There is yellow on the field. This one looks like it is coming back. We'll watch for the official call, but in the backfield, usually in the area of holding, as again, we all know, but we'll see what the call is here. It is holding against the Hilltoppers, so we will bring that touchdown back. Back them up 10 yards and replay that down. The second and about 17 here when they're all done. Depending on if this is a spot foul one or a line of scrimmage one. That side of the field opened up pretty easily. I guess we know why now at this point in time. So, second and 18 here. Big pressure. But Devitt is dropped. Dragged down, sacked, Menominee Falls. Tavier Johnson, Steven Scott in on that sack as they drag the Hilltopper quarterback to the ground. Big loss, big play for that Menominee Falls defense. Pushing the Hilltoppers all the way back. Third and 23 from their own 37-yard line. Have to get to the Menominee Falls 39. Devitt rolls left, throws deep. Nobody home. Intended for Peyton Robbie Brown. Peyton Roby Brown, apologies. So fourth down and forever now for the Hilltoppers. And they will punt for the first time today. Tysis Levitch deep for the Phoenix. Eric Schmidt handling both kicking duties now for the Hilltoppers as he will punt also. He falls with the pressure, but Schmidt able to get that away. Sis Levitch comes up, says get away from that one. That one hits at about the 32 and takes a little bit of a Marquette roll and gets down at around the Menominee Falls 27-yard line. And that is where they will start first and 10. That's got to help with the feelings a little bit for this Menominee Falls club. They find themselves down 21-0 with 6:22 remaining in the second quarter. And then we'll turn it over to the And Kirshner on the give. Joey Cook straight ahead. Cook bounces off a couple of tacklers. Short gain. Second and seven for the Phoenix.
Gain of four, second and six. Quality, 24
yards. So second and six, they're officially calling it here in the stadium, on the 24 yard line. It's a long six. Kirshner back to drop, feels a little pressure, but he's able to get that one away. Down the middle, and he is intercepted. Intended for number 13, Scotty Hawkins, and that is intercepted by number 21, Murphy Monreal. Unfortunate turnover there for Menominee Falls, not what they needed right now. So it's 5:34 now to play in the second quarter. Marquette takes over from the Menominee Falls 40-yard line, first and 10. Monreal was able to nicely step in front of that one. Out jump the Falls receiver and make that interception. Devin lays that one off. Little swing pass to Peyton Roby Brown. Roby Brown takes that one and scampers ahead. That'll be a first down for the Hilltoppers. Nice pick up on that play, well designed as he came in motion. Oh, and more penalties. Another holding penalty on the Hilltoppers. He'll bring that one back. Doesn't matter what yards they gain, they lose them all. That's the official call. So that'll take the ball. Depending on where it was, I hear they're saying it happened at the. There's a spot foul, so that means the holding happened downfield past the line of scrimmage. So that'll bring up second and eight. Novotny gets the toss. He gets hit and tripped up by Jake Grenier. Short gain there for the Hilltoppers. Third and, I guess we're second and seven here. Second and eight. That was a play ahead there. Second and eight for the Hilltoppers. Devitt, little play action. Intended for his main man, Cam Russell. Russell hit as the ball arrives, and that is knocked free. Incomplete, third and eight. Tysus Levitch. Played that one well, timed it well. Hilltoppers here, third and eight. Need to get to the Menominee Falls 30-yard line. Devitt takes a snap, drops, throws. Russell, nice little comeback, wide open, easy pitch and catch. Pick up 14, first and 10 for the Hilltoppers. 4:38 remaining here as the Hilltoppers on the move once again. Carried by number 26, Jack Dorley over the left side. Pick up of, looks like they're spotting, so it's about a pick up of about four. Second and six. Menominee Falls ball. What a play by Elm. He read that all the way.
He scored with the interception.
What a play by Elm. Diagnose, know what they're doing, make your break, make the interception. Menominee Falls starting out at their own 24-yard line, first and 10. Kircher, little out pass. Oh.
Incomplete
to Scott Hawkins. Hawkins, pickup of about 11, first down for the Phoenix. 4:07 remaining here in the second quarter. Menominee Falls feeling a little refreshed after that play by Eli Elm. Looking to make something of that turnover, their second of tonight's game.
Falls at the 35-yard line of the Phoenix.
Menominee Falls, three wide receivers. Holseth in the backfield. Joy Cook straight ahead. Cook out across the 35-40, up to about the 42-yard line. Nice pickup on first down. Second and three for the Phoenix. So, second and three for the Phoenix. Set up at their own 42-yard line. It's again, that H-back in the backfield. Straight ahead again to Cook.
Cook off the right side.
Not much there this time for Cook. Maybe a half a yard, maybe a yard. Third and three now for the Phoenix.
No gain on the play. Third and three.
Tysus Levitch coming in, giving Joey Cook a break. Don't see that too often here in this Menominee Falls offense, so we'll see what they have in mind here. Menominee Falls with three wide receivers, Piefer, Hawkins, and Johnson. Mason Holseth also out there as a receiver. It's just Levitch straight ahead. Bounces off, tackles. Pickup of four, Menominee Falls. First down, first and 10 from their own 45-yard line.
That's
first down. Nice job there by Sislevich, keeping the legs moving, driving through those tackles and those big bodies. Earned himself another play. Here we go. Kircher on the snap. Straight ahead to Sislevich. Sislevich again off the left side. Moves the legs. Finally stood up and pushed back, but pickup of three. Oh, we've got, I apologize, not this level, Grenier, Jake Grenier. Officials timeout though, we have an injured Phoenix on the field. And it is Grenier. They've got him, he tried to sit up, but they told him to lay back down. Hopefully just a cramp in the leg, nothing serious. Two pretty good hits, two pretty hard carries for the young man. 2:10 remaining here in the second quarter. Your score, Milwaukee Marquette 21, Menominee Falls 0. It has been all Marquette today. Menominee Falls with maybe 60 yards of offense so far today. Jake Grenier is up, and he is walking the sideline. A little hitch in the giddy up there, but looks like he's going to be all right. But Menominee Falls on the drive here, putting together a few first downs. Second and seven now for the Phoenix. And we wind the clock. We are underway. Kircher with Cook back in the backfield, three receivers. Mason Holseth, their standard setup. Kircher under pressure, nobody home, but he takes off. He is met and dropped by number nine, Josh Knacker, after a short gain. So third and, called third and four, but on the upside, this is the first time Menominee Falls has been in Hilltopper territory today. Small victories. So third and four, Kirshner straight ahead to Cook. Cook goes in the middle, but he bounces to the outside, and Cook turning the corner.
Joey Cook rambling around the right hand side. Finally brought down by Ryan Amundsen.
Brought down by Amundsen. see what. I see a flag. I thought I saw a flag on the field there, so we'll see the call here in a second. But unfortunately, the line judge looking straight down the line when he threw that. Usually a hold. Holding Menominee Falls. So nice run by Cook. Backed up. We will replay that third down. So after they march it off, third and 14 now. Back on their own 42-yard line. Johnson, Hawkins, and Piefer.
Officials timeout.
Yep.
Timeout,
Menominee Falls calling their first timeout of the half. Coach Regent Smith wants to talk about this one. Menominee Falls hoping to put some late first half points on the board here.
Varsity Dancing Coach, followed by the Junior Phoenix Cheerleaders.
Third and 14 upcoming here for the Phoenix. Again, not sure, depending on how close they get here. Not sure that this is four down territory, as this Marquette team has shown the ability to move the ball quickly.
I do want to congratulate the boys' volleyball team, which is now a sanctioned sport. This week they won their first match, being all Coastal West 3-1. This year's members are Kyle Bigger, Ben Pomeroy, John Herrick, Dane Rosser, TJ Tremont, Luke Ball, Drake Lundberg, Edward Alderley, Francesco Grifa, Lillingwood, Ben Coon, Sam Berkemer, Tommy Kofeski, and Nicker. Congratulations! It's your first Regional Conference victory.
Menominee Falls comes out, sending everybody out. Five receivers. Kirshner under quick pressure. And he is dropped. Marquette doesn't care. They bring the pressure. One, two, three. Bring six.
Final.
No single coverage on all of them, and it is fourth and forever for the Phoenix.
This Monday night, if you want to check out JV 1-2 at 5:30, the varsity will be hosting Port Washington.
Fourth and 19 from the Menominee Falls 37-yard line.
And time 7 o'clock.
Marquette calls a timeout.
Also Junior Phoenix time.
So they can draw up what they want to do here.
There's an article about Brookfield recent paper. Menominee Falls beat them 3-0. They went out to Germantown and beat Germantown 3-0. So a girls volleyball team is really on a roll. This year's members are Ellie Bruins, Cassie Bruins, members of Dennis Hotline, Lauren Sherman, Lisa Wolfman, Isabel Berkman, Tiny Harder, Brooke Niva, Danny Member, Lauren Corazari, Elena Miller, Cassie Anderson, and Karen Below. Congratulations to the girls' volleyball team. 6-0 against Brookfield East and Germantown.
So we'll see what Marquette talked about on this one. They already have one punt return tonight for a touchdown. See if they're setting up the return or if they're going to bring pressure to try to get this one. They have almost gotten two of Elm's kicks already today. I think they will set up. And Elm hits his best punt of the night. He drives that one all the way back. Monreal takes it on the high bounce back at the 15-yard line. He makes a couple of moves, a couple of Phoenix miss. A little bit of a stiff arm, and he turns the corner. Monreal all the way up to the 37-yard line after a great kick by Elm. And that is where Marquette will start. Just under 45 seconds remaining here in the second quarter. Working our way to half with Marquette leading the Phoenix 21-0. Devitt brings him out. Looks like they are going empty backfield, four receivers, got a tight end. Devitt Quick throw out here to the right side. He completes to number 17, Thad Hoffman.
Thad Hoffman. Wrapped up by Eli Elm and Colton Miller.
Colton Miller and Eli Elm taking him down. First and 10 after a pickup of 10.
Pass is complete from McDevitt.
And there's another catch there for Hoffman. McDevitt finds him again along the sidelines as they are just playing the sideline game right now. 28.8 seconds remaining. They are across midfield at the Menominee Falls 46-yard line, 47-yard line. This one straight ahead to Novotny. Novotny tries the middle, bounces it to the left. And Novotny scampers ahead to the, looks like about the 29, 30-yard line. Another first down here for Marquette. And based on what I've seen from their kicker tonight, I would say they are in field goal range for him at the very least. But they've got 20 seconds remaining, so I'm sure they're thinking other thoughts.
Ball's on the 25-yard line for Phoenix.
Here we go. First and 10 for the Hilltoppers from the Menominee Falls 25-yard line. Devitt takes a snap. Rolls right, throws back to Novotny. Novotny, lots of space, weaving through traffic, and he is into the end zone. No flags, and that one's going to stand. So with 11 seconds remaining here in the second quarter, and the score now, Milwaukee Marquette 27, Menominee Falls 0. Sure, it's fair to say not the first half that the Phoenix were hoping for, but we'll see what they come up with the plan. Unfortunately, Marquette receives the kickoff here in the second half, so they're going to get the ball again right away. Schmidt's kick is good. So 11 seconds, we will get one more kickoff, probably one more play, because every kick so far from Schmidt has been out of the end zone. And we'll take it to half at that point in time.
Also, I can congratulate Ryan and Phillips. Soccer team this week. Two big games. They held Brookfield East to a 1-1 tie. He scored in the last 7 minutes. First time they've been scored on all year. Their second state. Last night, Miami Falls lost 1-0 to Muskogee Central, who's number one in Division II. So the Miami Falls soccer team is on a roll. We'll read all the players' names in the second half.
So Schmidt ready to kick off here for the Hilltoppers. Shislevich and Beeks deep for Menominee Falls. 11 seconds on the clock.
There's
a run-up. And this one will also find its way into the end zone. And they will start at their own 20-yard line. So see if Menominee Falls is going to try anything here or if they're going to be fine with going into the half where we're at. Again, definitely not the showing they're hoping for. Both these clubs coming in identical 3-1 records, similar outcomes in all their games. But Falls just not able to get anything going here. Kirshner, a little quick pitch out to Hawkins. Pickup of 12. First down for the Phoenix. 3.5 seconds remaining.
That's good for Menominee Falls. First down. Last party at the run 32 yards.
So 3.5 seconds remaining, Menominee Falls sets up with three wide receivers. Mason Holseth at tight end, Cook in the backfield. And just a little give to Cook straight ahead. As he rumbles ahead for about nine, and that will give us the horn. So, two quarters in the books, not what the Phoenix wanted. They find themselves on the bad end of a 28-0 score against visiting Milwaukee Marquette Hilltoppers. We'll be back in just a little bit. Hope you enjoy tonight's halftime entertainment as we get the dance teams and then we get the pep band also. So enjoy. Thanks for sticking around with us here at Falls Cable Access, Spectrum Channel 14. I'm Marlon Hestetune, and we will be back in about 20 minutes with the second half.
The 2023-24 Varsity Dance Team, one of the best dance teams in the state of Wisconsin.
Awesome. I'm out there again.
Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. Quarter three about to get underway. Tonight we are here, we are Falls Cable Access at Menominee Falls High School. Spectrum Channel 14. I'm Marlon Hestatune. And tonight's Greater Metro Conference varsity football matchup to be visiting Marquette, Milwaukee Marquette Hilltoppers. And the Menominee Falls Phoenix, unfortunately not going the way Menominee Falls was hoping tonight's match would go. As your score after the half, Marquette 28, Menominee Falls 0. Menominee Falls getting set to kick off. Owen Moser doing the kicking duties for Menominee Falls on the kickoff. This will be his first one tonight.
Also on the football team is Corey Johnson.
Deep for the Hilltoppers, number 7, Tommy Novotny, number 21, Murphy Monreal.
Back deep is Tommy Novotny and Murphy Monreal.
Moses set the kick, and we are underway. This will be Monreal taking about the 10.
Murphy Monreal on
the comes back towards the strike. Spins out over the 20 to about the 24-yard line, and that is where the Hilltoppers will start off this third quarter.
Also a reminder, everyone, we want to thank Paul Stable Access 3043 coming up tonight. It's been a family affair. Get a chance, check them out. Paul Stable Access 1043.
So Peter McDevitt out to start his third quarter of work at quarterback. Lined up with Novotny in the backfield. And that is where this first give will go over the left side. Novotny out across the 30 to about the 32.
Down to Novotny. Tripped up by Nolan Anderson.
And they'll give him the 33.
And Matthew Bott. Need a 9.
Pick up 9, so second and 1. So they'll go right back to Novotny. He'll go more up the middle.
Tommy Novotny off the right side.
And he will pick up 3, and it will be first and 10 for the Hilltoppers. Marquette moving fast here in this first series of the second half.
First down, Marquette.
Devitt with a little swing pass out to Peyton Roby Brown. Falls incomplete. Menominee Falls felt that might have been backward, but it seemed pretty even online from where I'm sitting. So Marquette with their 28-0 lead, and it could have been worse. They had a couple of interceptions down into what is the red zone or almost the red zone on a couple of other drives, so definitely, I guess, be thankful for small miracles. Menominee Falls with those interceptions. Eli Elm coming away with both of them. One spectacular play where he jumped a pass attempt and made the interception. Novotny straight ahead on that carry. Just straight ahead power from him and his offensive line. Pick up a 15, and it is first and 10, and Hilltoppers are on the march once more. McDevitt with the fake, keeps rolls left, and overshoots a wide open Roby Brown. Second and 10 now for the Hilltoppers.
Pass was intended for Big Roby Brown. Brings up second down. Checking in is Matthew Bach.
Here we go, second and 10 from the Menominee Falls 48-yard line. Give it to Novotny, again back over the left side, and that is the side he likes.
Tommy Novotny on the left side.
Tripped up by Mason Lattice. Helped out by Eli Elm. Lattice got a hold of that ankle and brought him down, but not before Novotny had another first down. Devitt on the
Faked into Votnin, rolls right, finds Thad Hoffman. Thad Hoffman works his way up the field. Pickup of 23 on that one for Hoffman. First and 10 from the 11-yard line. They can get themselves a first down here, but Novotny again over the left side. Lots of space before he meets the first ball's tackle. A little bit of a cutback. Mason Lattis grabs on and goes for a little bit of a ride there as Novotny drags him down to right about the 1 yard line. Not sure if he quite got the first down. Can't see the sticks from here. Nope, second. Second and one. And why not? Straight ahead. Novotny takes it into the end zone. Touchdown, Milwaukee Marquette. For better or for worse, this has been, I hate to say, too easy for Marquette tonight. I mean, even the drives where they were intercepted, you know, that was, they were moving on both of those drives. So there's really only been one drive where the defense, helped by a couple of penalties, really stopped them and forced the punt. So this has been all Marquette tonight. And Schmidt's kick is good. So Marquette 35, Menominee Falls 0, 9:32 remaining here in the third quarter.
This is Squires, Weston Kinsler, Tim Miller, Finn Taylor, Ryan Walsh, Brady Poznanski, Noah Rice, Brandon Boldenberg, Jack Sapina.
Now that we are into the second half, Menominee Falls trailing by 35, I believe. We'll know here in a few moments. We'll see the running clock at this point in time, unless Menominee Falls can get under that 35-point differential. And just can't quite remember if it's second half or fourth quarter where we're at from when the running clock starts. But Menominee Falls, focus now, get some points on the board, stop the shutout streak, because as of right now, they have gone at least 2.5 games not giving up any points at all, this Marquette defense so far. So they shut out Brookfield East last week, 2 weeks ago they shut out Germantown, and now they are shutting out Menominee Falls. And Schmidt's kick, as all the rest of them have been, sails into the end zone. So Menominee Falls will start from their own 20-yard line, first and 10. Yeah, you definitely want to break that streak if you're the Phoenix. You want to get on the board, put some points up, and see if you can do a little bit of damage here. Again, things don't get any easier the next couple weeks. Brookfield Central next week, and 2 weeks after that, you play Sussex Hamilton. Both those schools ranked. Both those teams having good seasons. Oh, Kirshner fumbles that snap. Looks like Joey Cook was able to get on top of that one. Loss of one, looks like. They're marking it down. So second and 11 for the Phoenix. Kirshner's second down pass attempt. Tries to fit it in there to Quentin Pfeiffer. Unfortunately, double to triple coverage there. No luck. Pfeiffer not able to come down with that. Third and 11 now for the Phoenix. Talking back to that moment.
Pass is incomplete. Intended for Buddy Hawkins.
Kirshner's pass intended for Number 16, Corey Johnson. That one is high and incomplete, so 4th and 11 for the Phoenix, and Eli Elm will come on to punt. So, talking about this Marquette defense. 14 quarters. They've only allowed scores in 2 of those 14 quarters this whole year so far. And only given up 21 points total on the season. Eli Elm with a nice punt. Hits down on the Marquette 45-yard line, and Miami Falls downs it after a short Falls bounce. And it'll be first and 10 now for the Hilltoppers, starting from their own 44-yard line. So defensively, this is a good team. So we'll see if the Falls can find a way to break through and end that streak. Hilltoppers back out. We have a new quarterback. I apologize, I don't have a number 30 on my roster. Give is to Jack Dorley, straight ahead.
Quarterback is Luke Pacelli. Jack Dorley up the middle. Tackle by Matthew Bach with help on the play from Colt Miller. Official timeout.
So, new quarterback Luke Giacetti for Marquette University School. Injured players, number 26, Jack Dorley, after that run. Got himself a little nicked up, so hopefully we'll see him get up, be able to walk this one off. Sneaking a look ahead, Menominee Falls next week.
Let's have a nice hand for Jack Dorley.
Next week they line it up against Brookfield Central. Brookfield Central is out facing off against Sussex Hamilton tonight. So these three are going to, we'll see if one of them can get the upper hand or if they're going to do the one-and-one three-way circle. Said he's not able to hold on to that one. That one snaps through his hands. Tavier Johnson getting the easiest sack he'll ever get of his career as he walks up and is the closest player on that play. Here's Giacetti back to throw. His pass is incomplete. Intended for number 2, Ryan Czarnecki.
Brings up fourth down. Back in from Menominee Falls is Tyler Sizzler.
Menominee Falls looking to get off the field here from a defensive standpoint.
For the Hilltoppers is Eric Smith.
Marquette appears to, at least for that series, be willing to give some playing time to some guys whose names maybe don't get called all that regularly. Sislevich takes that one, picks up his own 15. Back up to about the 20. It'll be first and 10 for the Phoenix from that spot. Hunter Stuber with a nice rush on that punt attempt, but couldn't quite get there. And that is where we will start things off here with Menominee Falls, first and 10 from their own 20-yard line.
Hunter
Kirshner with Joey Cuck behind him. Two wide receivers. Mason Holseth and Tysus Levitch in the H-back and tight end spot, respectively. Cook tries the right side, a little heavier line, and Cook with his longest run of the day. Picks up about 16, maybe 17. It'll be first and 10, Menominee Falls.
First down, Menominee Falls. Stop by Josh Maffert and Patrick O'Brien.
First and 10 from their own 38-yard line for the Phoenix. Hawkins in motion. Kirshner, snap. Once again, you're straight ahead to Cook. Cook runs into a wall of human flesh. Nowhere to go. Knocked down. Looks like they're giving him a short gain. Menominee Falls got a little bit of a push there. Second and 9.
Help on the play from Bryce Ward. Gain of 1. Second and 9. Ball at the 39.
Kirshner with Holseth and Cook in the backfield. 3 wide receivers. Again, straight ahead to Cook.
Joey Cuck off right tackle.
Stop. Pick up of a couple there for Cook, so that sets up 3rd and 7 for the Phoenix.
Ball spotted at the 42-yard line. Picks up 3rd and 6.
So 3rd and 7 for the Phoenix. See what they have in mind here, how aggressive they want to be at this point in the game. Kirshner dumps that one off. Holseth takes a hit, stays on his feet, gets spun backwards, ends up losing a couple after the hit. That'll be 4th down now for the Phoenix. 4th and about 4. And we do have the running clock, as you can see. We are moving ahead. This third quarter rushing its way through as we are down under 2 minutes, down to a minute and a half here.
Open the door.
Looks like Menominee Falls will go for it here on 4th and 4 from their own 44-yard line. See what they do here. They give Kirshner a little bit of an option, see if he can make something happen himself with feet or legs. Roll him out to the right. Kirshner, he throws deep. But he has a man downfield. Oh, that one! Quentin Pfeiffer unable to haul that in. He was wide open past the defense. Pass was a little short, but off the hands, and he was unable to haul it in. So that is a turnover on downs for the Phoenix. Marquette takes over first and 10 from the Menominee Falls 44-yard line. We'll see. We may not even get another play here this quarter as we are now under 45 seconds and the clock is working its way to zeros on the third quarter. Marquette talking about what they want to do. And they're just going to let it run down because it was under 45 seconds, so they don't have to take a snap. They will happily move on to the fourth quarter at this point in time.
And that's the end of the third quarter.
There is your horn. 3 in the books, 1 to go. Marquette University Hilltoppers 35, Menominee Falls Phoenix 0. A little bit of confrontation on the Menominee Falls sideline as players are frustrated, as rightfully they should be. They've not looked strong tonight like they have the previous weeks, and Marquette has really owned this game. Mason Steinhoff now in at quarterback for Marquette. His first play, pass attempt. Intended for number 80, Will Grellinger.
Corbin, Also Tristan Hansen.
Stein offset. High snap, Steinhoff reins it in, keeps himself. Tries to make something happen, and he is dragged down. Corbin Nemeny on the tackle. Maybe one, nope, just made it back to the line of scrimmage. Third and 10 now for Marquette.
By Corbin Nemeny. Also, Lake Long Beach.
Steinhoff set. Little snap. Looks for a receiver.
Pass is incomplete to Mason Steinhoff. Pass was intended for.
Had a man open there. Will Clark, number 82, was the intended receiver. Clark had beat his man and made his break to the sideline, but Steinhoff unable to deliver the ball where he could make the catch.
0-4-5.
So fourth and 10 now.
I see somebody trying to scam us up here. But once again, 1-2-4. 0-4-5.
Marquette setting up for their punt here. Eric Schmidt on to do the kicking duties. Upon beaks deep for Menominee Falls. He will watch that one sail over his head. Oh, no. Oh. Hits along the sideline, checks up, finds its way out of bounds. It'll be first and 10 now for the Phoenix from their own 13-yard line. So the Phoenix with 9:27 remaining here. Trailing 35-0 to Milwaukee Marquette High School. And now we are set. The officials deem it okay to snap. Kirshner with the give to Joey Cook, straight ahead. Out to the 20-yard line, pick up of about 6. It'll be 2nd and 4 now. Menominee Falls just trying to get anything going here tonight. Had a couple times where they seem to get a little momentum, seem to be driving a little bit, but then they come up short, get stopped. One interception for Kirshner on the night for one of those drives. Second and 4, Cook starts right, heads back up the middle, but he is wrapped up from behind and dragged backwards. After a short gain, 3rd and 3 now. So here we go, 3rd and 4 for the Phoenix from their own 20-yard line. Kirshner and Cook in the backfield, 3 wide receivers. Kirshner sprints right. That one is
Batted down by Emilio Marone.
Emilio Marone and Cole Fisher falling on that one. Nice defensive play. Getting his hands up, knocking that pass down from Kirshner. And Eli Elm comes out to punt this one away. Even in a game like this, Regent Smith says, no, it's not worth giving up another one. Let's not give them a 20-yard field in case we don't make it. Elm's kick is away, traveling toward the sideline. Hits just past midfield and then bounces out at about the 40, 39-yard line. Things get a little chippy out on the field there. Nice job by Robert Green to be the peacemaker there, get in between players, send people to their sidelines. Letting cooler heads prevail on that one. So 1st and 10 for Marquette, starting from their own 40-yard line.
Marquette,
Luke Chiesetti heading back out for his second series of quarterback. Joined in the backfield by Judson Hansborough. Chiesetti's pass intended and caught by number 33, Kalen Ferber. Ferber makes it just about to the first down line. Let's see, just short. It'll be second and a very short one here for Marquette. Naquan Beeks in on the tackle there from Menominee Falls, leading that charge. Second and one now for the Hilltoppers. Chiesetti with the give to Hansborough. Hansborough straight ahead for about 11. That'll be good for first down for the Hilltoppers. First and 10 now from Menominee Falls, 41 yard line. That clock continues to tick, 5:20 now, and counting. Marquette, four wide receivers, running back in the backfield. Hansborough with the handoff. Steinhoff now in at quarterback. Hansborough straight ahead for
Austin Sanders.
About 3.5, second and 7. Marquette's had a pretty good pace all night, getting their plays in, getting to the line. Snap, Steinhoff looks to throw, and that pass overshoots his intended receiver, James J.J. Driscoll.
And the Falls lineup, number 30, C.J. Spence, and number 57, Ben Hassan. Brings up third and seven.
Third and 7 now for the Hilltoppers. And the Menominee Falls 38. They are rotating quarterbacks at this point in time. Giacetti's pass complete. He finds Kalen Ferber. Ferber up to the Hilltopper 33 yard line. It'll be 4th and 2 from Menominee Falls.
Once again, if you're in the rain, you still got your first communion money. All 4 of the concession stand is half place.
Giacetti in a quarterback. Hansborough in the backfield. Giacetti with the give to Hansborough here on 4th down. Hansborough straight ahead, breaks a few tackles. Touchdown saving tackle there by number 35, Evan Hoffman, as he gets down to the feet of Hansborough and brings him down. That will be good, though, for another Hilltopper first down. They keep this going with 2.5 minutes remaining. 1st and 10 from the Menominee Falls 18-yard line. Give to Hansborough straight ahead. He's met initially in the backfield, breaks a tackle. Gets wrapped up and pulled down by number 14, Joel Wolpert. Short gain, 2. Second and 8 now from the Menominee Falls 16. We are under 2 minutes to play here. As that clock continues to tick, 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 tick. Bad snap. Hansborough tries to recover, able to pick it up, but then he is swamped by Falls defenders.
down the aisle, squat rope, Joel Wofford.
Wofford right there, first man there. Makes the tackle. Loss for the Hilltoppers. Third and 14 now with 1:18 remaining counting. That's all right, third and 15. I'm 5 yards off. Apologies. Steinhoff on the snap. Straight ahead to Hansborough. Hansborough is taken down after a short gain. Fourth and 10 now for the Hilltoppers. And we are under a minute left in the game.
On the team that are played by C.J. Swintz and Joel Wofford. Back in from around the forest, Spencer Young.
We'll have one more play. We'll see if Marquette will run something or we'll just get a kneel down here and turn the ball over. But either way, it's not making much of a difference, I don't think, on the night. We'll get one more play. Little pitch to Hansborough. Hansborough makes the first man miss. Breaking tackles, trying to drag a couple people forward, but unable to get there. And with that, it'll be turnover on downs to Menominee Falls. Not sure that Menominee Falls, unless they're going to call a timeout, will get another play off. They run their offense out on the field, and we are down under 15 seconds. And with that, count down the final 9 seconds. Your final score, Milwaukee Marquette University School 35, Menominee Falls 0. Nice win for Marquette, tough loss for Menominee Falls. So Marquette leaves here tonight 4-1 overall, 3-0 in conference. Marquette moving on to the rest of the season with some tough games coming up. Menominee Falls leaving here tonight 3-2 overall. 2-1 in conference. And it does not get any easier, like we've talked about earlier, for this Menominee Falls team as they're learning all sorts of things about themselves this year. But next week, facing off against the perennially tough Brookfield Central, who look good again this year. Trying to find some results to see the results of the Sussex-Hamilton-Brookfield Central game, but unable to find those. But next week at Brookfield Central for the Falls. And then back here against West Alice Hale, and then another tough, tough game against Sussex-Hamilton. So two of the next three against state-ranked opponents. So once again, thanks for joining us. We're Falls Cable Access. I'm Marlon Hestatoon. It's been great spending the evening with you, watching some football here at Schumann Stadium at Menominee Falls High School. Thanks for joining us, and we will see you next time. Good night, everybody.